these four houses there, yeah, this side, because where, just here at the front of the building where you see our main red doors, mm-hmm, that was the carriage archway. That wasn't doors once. Okay. You come clippity-clopping straight through there.
So those at the back would have been stables?
Yeah.
Oh.
Where I live in stables. And okay, boy, don't I know it.
Wow.
But yeah, it's a lovely building. Come and take a look. It's a lovely, lovely place.
Yeah, a lot of history around it.
Trinity Bridge that's in Crowland.
That's the one over
down there. Yeah. The Tricorne Bridge.
Yeah.
The Japanese came over here during World War One, I believe, and spotted that bridge. They've built a replica of it somewhere in Japan. But interestingly, it's a tricorne. Put the tricorne together,
mm-hmm,
and a circle round it. What have you got?
Ryan, you tell me. It's a bit early for abstract imagination. You've
got the Hiroshima sign. What do you call it? It is too early.
we'll tell people, just take our word for it, folks.
You know the symbol that you'd wear around your neck for being anti-nuclear?
Yeah,
it's peace. That symbol, done.
It's got a name, isn't it? I can't remember the name.
I can't think of it at the minute, but
people know what you mean, yeah.
And there is a rumour that's...
CND, that's it.
CND, yeah, that's where it came from. In fact, the Japanese came to Crowland, saw that bridge, rebuilt it over in Japan.
Ah.
And obviously...
So Crowland, twinned with Japan.
Yeah, twinned with CND, stroke Hiroshima.
Oh, well, don't say that. That's not...
No, it's a joke.
But like you say, a lot of history around here. It's a nice drive down. I mean, it's just driving through cities all the way down. You've got Sheffield and Leicester and Nottingham, and then it's just country.
Yeah.
You know, and then you get to here.
Across Lincolnshire.
Yeah. It's nice.
Yeah.
Nice part of the world, this. So I definitely recommend people should come down here and, you know, you got people like Chris DOJ, well, he used to be known as Darren, innit? Darren DOJ and Mike Doherty and all of that. And I know they like to do their fair bit of travelling up and down the country, so maybe they can get down these sides. Maybe this is the new meeting point, you know, an
ex-free-racing place
now turned into our place.
Come down, we can smash the indentures up together.
Oh, I don't know, you know, you should look at them. You should read them and see what they say. People have put together agreements like that and they've stood the test of time, so there must be something in there that maybe we can learn.
Possibly.
I mean, just because someone says that word Freemason or whatever, they automatically these days associate it with something evil or something. It's not always the case, because there's a lot of people, as you know, who are in those things. They don't understand people's viewpoint when you say, oh, we're against Freemasons because they're causing all this evil in the world. And they think, but I'm just a normal person. I don't do any of that. I don't know any about that. It's the same with all walks of life. If we stop looking at it like it's all the police, it's not all the police. It's just those ones that's doing it, isn't it?
Yeah.
And the rest, you know, trying to do the best that they can do with the job, and they're trying to,
If we got rid of the corruptible manipulators, the people that are trying to do a good job could do the good job.
Or...
They could bring the others into line.
Or they could end up being the corrupt again, because... When we keep giving others this responsibility without giving it to ourselves, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's got to be ongoing.
But within that, they have to give us the respect of a voice and opinion and meet halfway, you say.
And that's when you know you've really got a problem, when people can't talk. So the art of conversation, which is a dying art because the face-to-face thing, needs to be brought about. That's all I'm trying to do. Bring back the art of conversation, the art of discussion.
I can do face-to-face. I do it all day long, most of the time.
Mm.
Yeah. My mum said I was born to do it. I'd walk off up the road from about the age of two talking to anyone. Come back here, kid.
Well, what I would definitely say, obviously, we met on Facebook, you know, and it just goes to show that you can meet nice people on the internet, but, you know,
it's good to meet so that you can let other people know, like you said, there are genuine people out there.
Yeah, exactly.
So, and you're not swimming in a sea of sharks.
Yeah, yeah. Because,
I mean, we've got the obvious ones that we know are just out there trying to do their best, and then you've got the obvious ones that you think, I would sit on the fringes because I know you're probably going to need help. But that's all you can do, isn't it? You can't.
Do your best, and God will do the rest, as they say. So, is there anything else you'd like to say before we sign off?
I'm coming down to London on the 6th of September for the protest for the children.
Okay.
So if anyone's going to come down, make the effort for the children.
Right. Make sure everybody stays safe.
Yeah.
No shenanigans, no silliness. No.
It's not about you.
It's not about your ego. It's about others. And if you're going to help others, then you have to do it.
Yeah. I'm leaving my business for the day. You know, going to come down possibly a night, overnight stay just for the children. I'm going to do it at least once.
Okay. Well, that's a nice thing, I think.
You know, I can't get out of this business very often because me and Jacob run it between us. We've sort of set skeleton staff, so...
Okay.
I do what I can when I can.
That's all we can do.
You know, and if people... Well, if you messaged me today and said, oh, da 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 da, help, I do what I can.
But the thing is that I find is people take advantage of that, and obviously you've had your fair share of stories there. We're all on a path of learning.
They're my lessons, though. Yeah. They're the lessons that I shouldn't have repeated.
But how can you not repeat them?
So that's a lesson in a lesson, if you like.
It's like you said yesterday, you got to give people an opportunity, because how will you know if you've already started saying, no, everybody's wrong, therefore no chance is offered. So you would never find out that bit of information that reveals what their character is really about.
Yeah.
So it's important to still maintain that good side of you, which we know people that like to take advantage of, but that can't be helped. That's one of our strengths and weaknesses at the same time. Because with that, we can find out who is who. So I'd prefer to give a bit of myself and find out, oh, that's a bad one, that. So I can, you know, like you burn your finger, I suppose. Yeah. I'd rather burn a finger than the whole body.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Just test the water. Oh, it's hot.
Yeah.
You know, jump in. Or... I met some lovely people. I've been down here as well. I've had a great time, as I say. And... I just hope that more people can get down this side of the world to come and see you. So where is it again?
The Abbey Hotel in Crowland, South Lincolnshire. It's 6 miles north from Peterborough. Good meeting point in the middle of the country. And, people from up north, down south. If you live in Cornwall, Michelle Penn.
A lot of people got like going down Cornwall as well, so you know, as part of a stop or a tour, it's nice. It's got the castles and everything as well that people like that go to see. There's lots of places to go and walk, and it's peaceful. I mean, this is Sunday, and you can hear how quiet it is apart from our noisy gobs.
Thank you for that. I'm going to go and help her now with the little baby.
You're welcome.
So she can come
down. Nice meeting you again. Yeah, you too, mate. Thanks. Okay, well, we'll sign off with that. Make sure you get down here, people. All right. One love.